10:30 international recording artist Kyle Mack. How's it feel to be signed to that record label now, Kyle?
Oh, man, it feels good. It's a dream come true.
Yes, indeed. We just heard a fantastic performance of Treat Her Like a Lady. Tell us a little bit about the recording of that song, Kyle.
Well, it was very full circle. You know, I grew up most of my life listening to The Temptations, was influenced in every way by them. Otis Williams is my mentor as well as my godfather, who was formerly of the group, Bruce Williamson. And so getting to go into the studio and record one of my favorite Temptations songs with the Temptations themselves is bananas.
Well, you certainly sound good on the song. You must have studied the group pretty much.
Oh, I studied ever since I was a little kid. You know, I first got wind of the Temptations history back when I was in fifth grade. You know, I've been studying them ever since, every move, every lyric, everything. So.
All right, we're going to let you do some dance a little later on. Huh? Okay, introduce your band, your music director.
This is my musical director, Mr. Dante Covert. He's been a good friend of mine ever since we were both in high school. And yeah, so I'm very big on keeping stuff in the family. And so when it came time for me to have this opportunity and go out on the road prospectively, there's no better choice that I could think of than Dante over here. I trust him. He's a good guy. He's very talented. And he knows his stuff. So, what more could you ask for?
We guys got some shows coming up soon, right?
We have some stuff coming up next year. We're supposed to be touring with The Temptations, so as the opening act, and we got some warm up stuff before the end of the winter. So we're gonna. Those dates are TBD, but.
That's gotta be. So you gonna be up there stepping on stage with them, too, Kyle?
Well, we just did. Actually, just recently, I did a performance in Ocean City with The Temptations, doing True Like Lady Live, mm-hmm. And we're gonna do that again sometime in the near future. Mm-hmm. So.
Why this music, Kyle? Now you're a young person. You know, your early 20s. A lot of this music was 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years before you were even born. How do you gravitate toward this music?
Well, I think it has a lot to do with me being, my parents would work almost every day when I was a child, and I spent a lot of time being babysat by my grandmother, and she introduced me to a lot of more old school music, and I remember the sound of the Drifters, especially on that song White Christmas, was something that really resonated with me. And so progressing from there, just the old school R&B, the groups with their harmonies and the choreography and just the overall class, and the way music used to be written with such artistry and melodies, and you know, wasn't the same four chords every, you know, the entire song, you know. But just there's something that resonates with me with classic music, and I take a lot of inspiration from that and from the artists of that day.
Now, talk about writing songs, Kyle. Do you do any songwriting on the album?
Yeah, well, this on this first EP, the first three tracks are going to be Temptation songs. It's kind of like I said before, a collective like love story for how much the group has meant to me and influenced me through the years. But the last track on the EP is a song called Here I Am. Song actually I've been sitting on for 5 years, and then I showed it to Otis Williams and he loved it. He helped me tweak it a little bit, so now we're co-writers on the song. It's kind of like a self-declaring title. Here I am, you know. So we're gonna transition. That's the transition point to original music from this point on.
Mm-hmm. Now, who are some of the other artists that influenced you to want to sing, Kyle?
I love Maxwell. I love Maxwell. I love his range and his talent and the whole what he had done for neo soul was just amazing. I love Anthony Hamilton. Majority of the artists I listen to is, you know, probably Motown artists, the Four Tops, Marvin Gaye, Smokey Robinson, all those people. But the R&B artists of today, like the really talented ones, like, you know, Eric Benet and Jill Scott and folks like that, they're doing wonderful things with R&B music now. We want to make sure that gets heard.
Now, you mentioned some of the current artists, and you also mentioned some of the artists from back in the day. Why is it important to keep that original sound, that classic, traditional sound of R&B alive? Why is it important?
Because it's the derivative of everything. You know, we as R&B artists today would not be much if it wasn't for what these people that came before us. You know, if it wasn't for what they had done and the way they paved the way. So.
Okay, well, I wish you much success with your new album, your EP, and your tour. The album is out now, so if folks are interested in learning more about Kyle Mack, how can they find out more about you and your music?
Well, you can go to my Facebook page, Kyle Mack, and remember, Mack is spelled M-A-A-C-K, that's two A's. And I'm on social media with Instagram and Twitter. We're just building all this stuff. I came to the game a little late on social media, but we're making it work. Our website will be kylemackofficial.com when that comes up. And also you can find out information on the Temptations official page, the temptationsofficial.com. There'll be information about me on there too. And so the EP will be released on everything. You go on iTunes, Spotify, Apple Music, everything, you can find it. So.
All right, we thank you, Kyle Mack, and your music director, Dante. Thank you so much for being part of the show here today. We appreciate you coming by R&B Showcase Live, and we look forward to hearing more of your music and seeing you out on the road.
Yes, sir.
Let's all continue to support live music. This is Tim Marshall for R&B Showcase Live. Hi, this is Tim Marshall. Many of you know me for the R&B Showcase radio show. Well, I'm here to tell you about the brand new TV program coming soon to Comcast, Verizon, and On Demand. It's called R&B Showcase Live. We'll have special guests live in the studio, recording artists, entertainers, educators, and community leaders. Plus, we'll be playing and presenting the same great music, such as the R&B, Motown, pop, soul, jazz, gospel, blues. Check us out online at rhythmandbluesshowcase.com.